This week on Exposed, a probe against Speak Asia gains ground with the Mumbai police unearthing fresh evidence. Company maintains its denial. Price rigging continues rampantly. We bring you the modus operandi of another scam. And finally, the commodities market regulator wakes up to rampant malpractices in our commodity markets. Hello and welcome to Exposed. This is the show that tracks down economic criminals and uncovers scams that hurt you and your hard-earned money. Controversial survey company Speak Asia has been making headlines as authorities investigate the possibility of an alleged 2,000 crore rupee scam. Investigative agencies say they have made headway in their probe, even as the company maintains its denial to all charges. We bring you exclusive details on the Speak Asia investigation.
Online survey company Speak Asia asserts that people can join the company free of cost. However, as per the company's website, panelists must subscribe to the company's e-sign survey today by paying 6,000 rupees for a subscription of 6 months or 11,000 rupees for a yearly subscription. According to Mumbai's Economic Offences Wing officials, it is evident that the company is actually in the business of money circulation.
This is a mega fraud where a lot of money has actually been already invested by the investors. Some of them have got their money back because it is a typical money circulation scheme. There are a couple of reasons. The first is this company promises that one after you give them 11,000 rupees, you will start getting two surveys per week, which will fetch you 1,000 rupees, which amounts to around, if a year has a 52 weeks, then 52,000 rupees. But it also says that you can encash the points after 30 days, which means that they have available this money for 30 days for recirculation among themselves. Apart from that, the investigations as of now have told us that essentially there is no client for whom they are doing any kind of surveys. They had given name of certain big companies in India who all have denied that they have ever contacted Speak Asia. So now if there is no clientele who is buying the product, so from where the money is coming? That itself speaks about the circulation of the money in the market.
Close on the heels of an FIR filed by a Speak Asia panelist, the EOW Mumbai kicked into action and nabbed 4 top officials. Police has also sealed the offices of Speak Asia's website management company, Tulsi & Consultancies, which is based in Mumbai. Shockingly, Tulsi's managing director, Manoj Kumar, is also the CEO of Speak Asia.
During the course of investigation, we learned that the people are trying to gradually move out of the country, and their CEO, Manoj Kumar Sharma, had left the country. That is how we moved into action and arrested the chief operating officer, Mr. Tarak Bajpayee. Apart from him, we have arrested other people as well, who are the so-called heads of various branches of Speak Asia in India. And then we gradually learned that Speak Asia is actually operating its entire web portal, maintaining it from Mumbai itself, though the server and other things are located abroad. And the office head and the technical in charge of this were also arrested, and they have today been remanded for further police custody till 12th of August, and our investigations are on.
Speak Asia's latest offering for the panelists is a series of electronic products. Their website claims that these products are made by a German company called Yug. However, Exposed tried tracking Yug only to discover that no such company exists in Germany. According to our sources in the Income Tax Department, Speak Asia had defaulted on their service tax payments. As a result, Speak Asia had to cough up 54 crore rupees as tax liability. Speak Asia's money trail also led the IT department to discover that the company has siphoned off nearly 640 crore rupees out of India. The EOW has also investigated many financial irregularities and are estimating the alleged fraud size to be more than 2,000 crore rupees.
It is a typical money circulation scheme where the pyramid, as the pyramid grows, so the last, the people at the very bottom of the pyramid normally suffers in such cases, and that is what we are anticipating in this also, because the company itself is claiming that they have more than 20 lakh investors in India. And if we calculate it with the amount of 11,000 per person who might have invested, then the figure runs into more than 2,000 crores.
According to police officials, they have now narrowed their hunt and are looking for the kingpins of this alleged fraud, namely Harain Kaur, the chairman, and Manoj Kumar, the CEO of Speak Asia. Police officials say that they may even issue a red corner notice against Speak Asia.
Two wanted accused in this case, one is the CEO, Mr. Manoj Kumar Sharma, and the other is a lady called Harinder Kaur, who is supposedly the chairperson of the Speak Asia and Heron Ventures Private Limited, which these two companies being registered in Singapore. She is the chairman of these two companies, and we are told that these companies are actually owned by a company called Podium Ring International, which is registered in British Virgin Islands.
Despite the allegations against Speak Asia, Manoj Kumar, the CEO of the company, recently posted a video on the company's website, assuring panelists that the company is optimistic of the future. Manoj Kumar also openly stated that all allegations against the company are false.
We have now been subject to an unparalleled victimization since 11th May 2011. We have left no stone unturned in our effort to approach the concerned authorities. And to this end, your company had also approached Honorable Mumbai High Court. And you're aware, the Bombay High Court had asked RBI to give your company a hearing. We had approached EOW Mumbai on 15th May, 17th May, and after that, our lawyers met them. The idea was, and they have interviewed our distributors. Our idea was to provide them with all the information that they need, cooperate with them in every sense they want, and we still would continue to do so. We are not going anywhere. We have only one way to go, and that is to go forward.
Speak Asia, through various channels, through mouth to ear campaign, and also through mails and other things, are trying to give a wrong impression to the people. In fact, they have even been telling that Mr. Tarak Bajpayee has not been arrested, he has been detained. All these are false things which they are saying. And also their CEO appeared some day back on a YouTube, and he tried to tell them that we are going forward and have patience. So many people still feel that maybe that tomorrow the money will come to them. And this hope, they are still holding back because they have no other option. But gradually, we have also started receiving a lot of complaints from other people. And we will also take legal recourse, whatever is available with us, to ensure that these kind of fraud companies don't operate from here.
Authorities claim they have evidence against Speak Asia that could help strengthen their case against it, and that could well decide which way the case goes and what happens to lakhs of its member panelists, who now wait with bated breath as this case unravels. In light of the many scams that have come to books recently, police officials are sounding caution against schemes that seem too good to be true.
No market in the world today is operating at the range of 150% to 200%, whereas this company was promising 500% return in any year. So any investor who is lured by these kind of schemes, I am told there are many schemes which says that you pay so much amount and then you watch some ads and then you will be paid X amount. We are also going to investigate all these kind of schemes, and more so the education of the public and the campaign to the public to make them more conscious, more aware, especially in the rural area, is required. Government of Maharashtra has recently launched an initiative whereby we will be addressing to the people and telling them to be more careful about such schemes.
Time for a short break on Exposed, but on the other side, SEBI's order on a group of entities reveals the modus operandi of stock price rigging. Stay tuned to Exposed. Welcome back. You're watching Exposed. Exposed had earlier cautioned investors to beware of the deeply rooted nexus between some promoters and some operators. Our investigation revealed the menace of rampant rigging of share prices and how this poses to wipe away the hard-earned money of thousands of small investors. Now, a recent order by SEBI brings out the modus operandi adopted by Sanjay Dangi, who has been accused of perpetrating a scam. Neha Bothra has the story.
On the 19th of July this year, SEBI had issued an order in the matter of Sanjay Dangi, his associates and other entities. The 31-page order was in continuation to an ex parte order passed by SEBI on the 2nd of December 2010. Importantly, the order dated 2nd December had barred the Dangi Group entities from trading in the securities market. These entities comprised Mentor Capital Limited, Amit Business Limited, Ashok Finstock Limited, Ivory Consultants Private Limited, Sanjay Dangi, Sunil Dangi and Alpana Dangi. This order also banned Ashika Stock Broking and 14 other entities from dealing in securities. The Ashika Group comprised 14 other entities that included Calcom Consultancy Services Private Limited, Micromanagement Limited, Winol Winmare Private Limited, and Delight Tire Private Limited. Here are a few instances in SEBI's order that clearly explain the modus operandi of the promoter-operator nexus. SEBI had initiated the investigation to probe manipulation in the shares of 10 entities that include Murli Industries, Akriti City, Wellspun, Rushman India and RPG Transmission. The market watchdog's preliminary investigations indicated that the Dangi Group entities had influenced the share price of these scrips. For instance, the Dangi Group allegedly manipulated the shares of Murli Industries Limited during the pricing period of the company's FCCB. After the completion of the FCCB issue, MCL, an entity of the Dangi Group, exited the stock at a profit. MCL made a case by saying that the stock price went up to 1200 rupees, while they exited the stock at a much lower price of 603 rupees. The order states that this move was made with the intent of covering an alleged agreement between MCL and the promoter of MIL. Moreover, in-depth investigation also enabled SEBI to establish that the relationship of the Dangi Group inter alia with Ashika Stockbroking allegedly went beyond the normal client-stockbroker relationship. SEBI's order states that the Dangi Group and Ashika Group were allegedly involved in rigging up the prices of a company called Brushman. Further, the managing director of Brushman was given 8 lakh shares in companies that belong to the Ashika Group, namely Splendor Vanijia Private Limited and Delight Tire Private Limited. SEBI realized that these companies had woven a complicated web when they discovered that Ashika's entity Delight had a stake in Dangi's company Amit Business Limited, while the other Ashika entity Splendor was also marking off market transactions to Dangi's company Amit Business Limited. They also found that Amit Business Limited was a stakeholder in Ashika's entity Splendor Vanijia Private Limited. According to SEBI's order issued on the 19th of July, the group of entities were allegedly trading the identified shares through Ashika Stock Broking to manipulate the share price and volume of these scrips. For example, the order reveals that Dangi and Ashika Group entities had actively traded in the shares of Wellspun by allegedly synchronizing the trading pattern. SEBI's order says, and I quote, "Moreover, it is observed that the Dangi Group and Ashika Group entities have time and again come together in a coordinated manner, serving much like the mercenaries on hire for execution of fraudulent schemes in the securities market. The ulterior objective of the promoters and the operator was not known to the investors, who therefore got induced to deal in the shares of companies without full information and suffer erosion of value on their holdings when Dangi and Ashika Group entities suddenly exit the scrip. The nexus between different promoters and the Dangi Group therefore emerges repetitively as the Dangi Group successfully offers its services for a commercial consideration, a contract that jeopardizes investor interest and violates the tenets of the securities market." End of quote. Clearly, the Indian stock market seems to be gravely compromised. In fact, on the 11th of July, in a different investigation, Exposed had unearthed the modus operandi of some unscrupulous market players. Our hidden cameras revealed how some operators were allegedly rigging stock prices and misleading investors.
वो आप लोग मिलके कैसे काम करते हो लाइक
कभी कोई तस्करी आ गया और कुछ इन्वेस्टमेंट वो लोग करते हैं कुछ मैं करता हूँ तो वो काम साथ में करते हैं कभी मार्केट में एग्जिट रूट नहीं है तो सबकी वही प्रॉब्लम है क्योंकि मेरा काम भी इन्वेस्टमेंट का नहीं हम लोग तो जो पूरा स्टेक अगर परचेस कर लेते हैं कंपनी का जो इसको डाइल्यूट करना है वही काम करते हैं
कैसे करते
जैसे हमने 100 रुपीस में स्टेक ले लिया और रेट 400 500 हो गया उसका तो 500 400 में हमारी एग्जिट होती है वही फायदा होता है अगर कंपनी को डाइल्यूट करना है 10 लाख से 20 लाख से 40 लाख से तो हम एक साथ ले लेते हैं बोमन
आईपीओज में जैसे होता है वैसे ही
हाँ आईपीओ में और कुल मिला के पूरा एक फायदे का काम मतलब इसमें लॉस नहीं होता होल्ड करना पड़ता है कई बार
तो आप लाइक किसके थ्रू करते हैं
ब्रोकर्स बहुत सारे ब्रोकर्स नीचे ऑफिस में सब टर्मिनल लगे हुए अहमदाबाद ऑफिस में भी लगे हुए हम लोग तो बल्क स्टॉक ले लेते हैं और वही स्टॉक की एग्जिट कर देते हैं क्या बल्क का मतलब होता है जैसे 200-300 रुपया रेट चल रहा है और मैंने कंपनी से डील 50 रुपये में कर लिया और कंपनी को चाहिए एक साथ 50 करोड़ रुपये वो मैंने दे दिए ठीक है तो और उसका रेट मैंने बढ़ा के कर दिया जो जो माल मैंने 50 करोड़ में लिया उसकी मार्केट वैल्यू 500 करोड़ रुपये तो मैं उसको सेल भी करूँगा तो मेरे को 150-200-250 वो तो आएगा तो ये होता है पूरा बल्क बहुत बड़ा काम है बहुत बड़े डील होते हैं अथॉरिटी को ये ऑब्जेक्शन होता है जैसा हम लोगों ने बल्क स्टॉक ले लिया उसके बाद उसको मैनिपुलेशन करके रेट ऊपर कर दिया बढ़ा लिया तो वो जो मैनिपुलेशन होता है उनसे अथॉरिटी को प्रॉब्लम
तो वो आपके हाथ में थोड़ी ना प्राइस ऊपर नीचे करना
वो तो जो बल्क स्टॉक लेता है वही करता है जैसे मैं मेरे पास बल्क स्टॉक है तो मैंने मार्केट से और 10 लाख उठा लिया तो रेट तो बढ़ जाए साल में 4-5 काम कर लिए तो 100 करोड़ मिल जाता है इससे ज्यादा पैसा कोई बिजनेस में इससे ज्यादा पैसा थोड़ी आता है
While scamsters will always be one step ahead of regulators, you as an investor would do well to refrain from investing in stocks solely on the basis of sharp jump in share prices. Time for a short break. On the other side, Forward Markets Commission finally wakes up and starts a crackdown on illegalities in the commodity markets. Keep watching Exposed. You're watching Exposed. All is not well in our commodity markets. In less than a week, the FMC has cracked down on 3 instances of manipulation. The latest being a case of alleged embezzlement by the former managing director of one of the commodity exchanges. FMC alleges that nearly 50 crore rupees were siphoned off. The commodity watchdog has asked NMCE to initiate legal action and is probing the possible violation of FEMA norms. But this is just one of its order. It's also cracked down on 2 commodity brokers. Here's the story.
The commodity regulator has woken up from its slumber. In a 96-page order issued on the 23rd of July, FMC has accused Kailash Gupta, the former managing director of the National Multi-Commodity Exchange, of breaching his responsibility towards the exchange's board of directors and shareholders. According to the order, Gupta allegedly defrauded NMCE to bring about illegal monetary benefits to his family and close associates. Gupta allegedly violated the Forward Contract Regulation Act and Foreign Exchange Management Act. The order says, and I quote, Kailash Gupta has cheated the NMCE, its board of directors and its shareholders, thereby attracting the provisions of Section 418 of the IPC. And has committed fraud on them, thereby attracting the provisions of Section 420 of the IPC, by not disclosing his and his family's interests or the other conflict of interests while appointing Arrow Total Solution LLC, ATS LLC, California, USA, and Messrs. Arrow Total Solutions Private Limited, Ahmedabad, as the software vendors of NMCE, of which he was the MD, and settling the terms of the contracts with it. End of quote. According to the order, Kailash Gupta is the managing director of Neptune Overseas Limited, and Neptune Overseas Limited reportedly is also the anchor promoter of NMCE. In its order, FMC alleges that Gupta abused his position by wrongfully getting the shares of NMCE allotted to Neptune Overseas Limited, which is reportedly owned and managed by Gupta and his family members. The order states that Gupta allegedly caused the allotment of NMCE shares to Neptune Overseas Limited with a fraudulent transfer of funds from NMCE to Neptune Overseas Limited. The order states, and I quote, Kailash Gupta is hereby held guilty of grossly abusing his executive fiduciary position as the managing director and later as the executive vice chairman of the NMCE for causing wrongful and illegal monetary benefit to the firms and companies controlled by him or his close relatives at the expense of the exchange, and is therefore declared as a person not fit and proper to hold any position in the management and the board of any exchange recognized or registered by the Government of India, Forward Markets Commission or any other financial market regulator. It is further ordered that no company controlled by him, either directly or indirectly, including the NOL, shall hold shares in any association or exchange recognized by the government or registered by the FMC in excess of 2% of the total issued capital of the association or exchange. End of quote. Prior to this order, the FMC has also come down strong on other cases on manipulations. On the 26th of July, the FMC passed a suspension order against a Mumbai-based commodity broking firm called Rank Commodities. FMC has suspended the company from trading for 2 years and charged two of its directors, Sunil Mirpuri and Hemal Jayantilal Thakkar, for illegal activities like misuse of client funds, unauthorized transfer of funds from one client to another, and dealing in cash through hawala operators. Similarly, on the 1st of August, FMC stated that a Hyderabad-based broking firm, Rupia Investments, has been booked for illegal trading. According to FMC's statement, they received a complaint against this private firm, which was forwarded to the Hyderabad police under Rule 13 of the FCRA.
India's financial system is being compromised by some scamsters. Illegal practices of all kinds are brimming in our markets. Be it Speak Asia's elaborate money trail, the well-oiled nexus of a few operators and promoters, or certain government officials filling their own pockets. That's why, on our part, we will continue to caution you, because we believe the truth must be exposed.